Hello guys, very welcome back. Now a basic question arises. Now if you want to make any body tomorrow, okay, how will you decide whether it should be statutory, constitutional or none of this? Before that, what are statutory, constitutional and executive body? Let me clarify that. Next video we'll also see what is the thought process to make any body under this. By the term body, I mean UPSC as a body, CBI as a body, RBI as a body. Okay, so that's the body. Why CBI is a statutory body, not constitutional body? So that's the thought line. Before that, what are these? Let me explain. So constitutional body, as the term suggests, it's a body which derives its power from the constitution. UPSC has articles mentioned, article 323 is in the name of UPSC. Election commission has an article. Finance Commission has articles, CAG has articles, C&AG, okay? So when a body comes from constitution, it's a constitutional body. When a body is made by enacting a statute, what is statute? Statute is a law. So when Parliament makes a body, it's known as statutory body. That is, after making law, the body is formed. For example, CBI was formed from Delhi Special Police Establishment Act 1946. Chief Vigilance Commission, it was a body formed from CVC Act 2004. National Human Rights Commission was framed. The body was made from NHRC Act 1993, RBI Act, SEBI Act, CIC, Chief Information Commission was made from RTI Act 2005, LCI, Law Commission of India, was again made from forming a parliamentary law. So a body which is made by enacting statute, which is law, is known as statutory body. The body which is made by the executive orders, for example Niti Aayog, Planning Commission, are executive body. I think I'm quite clear with all the three, right? Next video we'll see what is the thought process that CBI should be a statutory, not a constitutional. See you.